All right, so today's topic is going to be a little bit interesting, as it's something that I've never really covered before. But today I'm going to be giving you guys some different solutions that you can use to fix a raw hard drive on your Windows computer. So what is a raw drive or a raw hard drive? Well, in the simplest terms possible, it's just a drive that the data cannot be read on. And this is oftentimes due to a bad file system or a corrupted file system, which can happen for a multitude of reasons. From the drive being formatted incorrectly to using an obscure file system that isn't even recognized by Windows, or tampering or adjusting the file system in some way that makes it obsolete, or even just letting the drive sit too long or a power outage while it's plugged in, can all contribute to this happening, but the result is pretty much always the same. Plug the drive in and either nothing happens or it tells you that you need to format the drive in order to fix it. Both of which are not exactly desirable outcomes. So what do you do? Well, before you do anything, you should stop using the drive and refrain from using it as much as possible to avoid further corruption and overwriting of the files on the drive. So that'll just give you the best chance of recovering as much stuff as possible. So that's a quick tip for you right there. Yeah, I would highly advise that you watch this tutorial all the way through, or at least watch this first method before you give anything else a chance. And that'll, again, be the safest for your drive overall. Okay, so let's just jump right into the first method of recovery here, which is going to be using file recovery software to pull the data off the drive, even though it's raw. Now, while technically the fastest way to gain access to your drive and to actually make it usable again is to format the drive, we don't recommend this because it comes with the obvious drawback of erasing your data. I'll get to this more later, but for now we're going to stick to recovery software, which in my opinion is going to be the best first course of action for getting the most stuff off your drive, and then you can format it later. So the software we're going to be using today is called Disk Drill, and it's one of the best in the industry. It comes standard with all the tools you need to not just recover your files, but back up and further protect them as well. With one of the most advanced file recovery algorithm systems in the space, it puts all the power you need right at your fingertips, and you can recover up to 500 megabytes of files for free if you download the Windows version, which is pretty sweet. So let's get started and go ahead and download and install Disk Drill from the link in the description. And once it's downloaded, go ahead and open it up. And here you'll see you'll be brought to the data recovery panel, which shows you a list of all the drives that are connected to your PC. Now all you need to do is click on the hard drive that is raw, and select your scanning method, and then hit search for lost data. All right, so now that we've started the scan, what I'm gonna do is just let it run, not touch it at all, as that's important for raw drives, and I'll come back to you once it's done and we'll pick up from there. All right, so the scan has finished. Now what we can do is just click this button right up here, which will allow us to review all the files that were found during the scan. You can review them in the middle in this sort of folder Windows Explorer structure right here. There's also some categories on the left-hand side. There's also a search bar in the top right if you happen to know the file by name. But once you find the files that you're looking for, just put a check mark next to them, which will select them for recovery. Then go down and hit recover. And choose your save location to export the files to. Now I do want to say it's really important that you do not recover the files to the same drive you're trying to recover from. So do not export them to your external hard drive. Just export them to your desktop or somewhere on your C drive or even another external drive that's a safe location that is not the drive you're trying to recover from. Very important. So I'm just going to go ahead and select my desktop and click OK. And once it's finished, you'll have the files back in your hands, just like they never left. So that first method is obviously super solid, and it's the one that I recommend to just about everybody that's looking for data recovery. But what else can you do, right? Like something that's more simple or something that is a lot quicker? Well, there's a few things that you can try. And the next thing I would try is actually another piece of software called Test Disk. This is a free open source software that, while it is simple, shows a lot of promise in this area specifically. Inside the software, you have the ability to scan a drive and correct corrupted blocks, rebuild a boot sector, and even undelete files. Now, for the sake of time, I don't have the time to actually go like deep dive into detail the process of using Test Disk to actually recover and restore functionality to your drive, but I have made a video about it before. I've also written about it, so I will link both of those down below in the description to where you can get some more information, as well as the official Test Disk website. Okay, now if all else fails, you still can't get the stubborn thing to return and you can't get your files off, then it's time to look at formatting. So you've probably heard of formatting before, and yes, it's true, it completely resets the drive and thus deletes all of the data on it, restoring it to its factory state, essentially. However, one important distinction that I want to make is that when you format a drive, you have the option to select a quick format. And what that means is that it's still going to reset the drive and reset the file system and delete everything, but the data is technically still there. So you would still be able to run, say, a data recovery software scan on it and potentially recover things even after formatting. So that's a really important point that I want to make, is that even though we're going to be formatting, we're going to be using the quick format, which will still allow for a further recovery effort to take place afterwards. So not all hope is lost, even though we are formatting. So just keep that in mind. But to format the drive, just open File Explorer and then right click on your drive, then hit format. Then in the window that comes up, leave all the options as default, except change the file system to exFAT, and then make sure you enable the quick format option. And that's it. Just click on start, and that'll format the drive. Okay, so now once you're finished with the format, I highly recommend that you go back to the first method and scan the drive with Disk Drill, that data recovery software, and that should give you a decent shot at actually pulling data off the drive even after a format. That's how powerful Disk Drill is. So I'd really, really recommend that you give that a shot as a follow-up to a format. But there you go. As far as a raw hard drive goes, that's about the most that I would be able to throw at it in terms of restoring functionality and getting data back off the drive. I really hope that this helped you guys and that you found this video useful. And if you did, always be sure to leave us a like down below and a comment. I love reading your guys' comments all the time. But that is going to be it for today's video. My name is Andrew, and until next time, thank you for watching.